Lord, I thank you because your love endures, Father God. Hallelujah. It conquers all, Father God. He conquered it all on the cross. I thank you because your mercy and truth, Lord God, endure forever. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your word tonight. I thank you, Lord God, for preparing the hearts and the minds. I thank you that you sent the angels to prepare the way, Father God. And Lord God, I thank you that you're breaking up the fallow ground. I thank you, Lord God, that you're opening up deaf ears. Lord God, and blinded eyes, Father God, I thank you that you're taking out hard hearts and giving us a heart of flesh. I thank you, and I thank you, Lord God, for what you're doing in our lives. I thank you, Lord God, that your words will not return to your void, but they will accomplish that which you sent it to do. For you are God, and you're God all by yourself, Lord God. Hallelujah. One man plants, another man waters. But Lord God, you give the increase. And I thank you, Lord God, for the increase. Increase in knowledge, wisdom, and love, and joy, and peace. Lord God, an increase in souls, Lord God. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Thank God. Amen.
Amen, amen.
Trust in the Lord at all times. Pour out your heart before him. Power belongeth to God. God has spoken once and twice have I heard this. Power belongeth to God. Who can search his understanding? His thoughts are harder than I. All power's in his hands. For my life he has a plan. God is our salvation. And we find refuge in him. Power belongs. Power belongs to God.
Yes, he is.
Amen.
Yes, he is.
So the topic, we're going to read Psalm 62:11 together. You guys see it? All right, it starts off, God has spoken. Ready? Read.
God has spoken once. Twice shall I hear him.
That power belongs to God. Amen. Brother Kenny, you got that? So the psalm is David. Right? The prophet David, the King David, he said, I heard the Lord speak once. Now I heard God say it twice. That power belongs to God. Amen. And we're going to read the subtopic together, 63:1-2. All right? Starting out with, oh God. Ready? Read.
Oh God, you are my God. Early will I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh longs for you in a dry and thirsty land where there is no water. So I have looked for you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory.
Everybody get that? So in other words, what the psalmist is saying is, one, he heard God say, power belongs to him. Amen? And he said, I look for God in a dry and thirsty land. In other words, you know what? There's nobody else worth looking to during a time of trouble. Amen?
Amen.
So
Amen.
When things are bad, I'm looking for something. I'm in a dry and thirsty land. And he says, I'm looking for you early in the morning, Lord God. When I'm in a time of trouble, I look for God. I look to see God's power and glory because I know power belongs to God. Amen?
Amen.
So the topic today Amen. Is power belongs to God. And when you're looking for something, you're looking for some power and you're looking for some help, you need to be looking for God. Amen. You need to be seeking God. Amen. And you don't need it. And I'm going to tell you something about God. As we're going to read, it says, we'll come back to that part. Amen. But Jeremiah 10:12 says, God's omnipotent. He's omni, powerful. He says he has made the earth by his power. He has established the world by his wisdom. Everything that is made, that was made, God made it. Now I'm not talking about that house, amen, but the wood that you needed to build that house, God made it. the glue that you need to stick in the nails, the metal. God made everything. And he put it in man's heart and mind how to do some things. He gave us a brain. He gave us a thing. A brain to think. He gave us some talents. Amen? Amen. But you need to know that not everything that was made, the Bible says, was made by him. And it was by his wisdom. In other words,